What's up, everyone? Me, JP2 here. And in today's video, we have Leaf Storm Lurantis. Now, to add to that, I'm also running Trailblaze, which can boost the Leaf Storms further, which is just insane. Because Leaf Storm is a grass-type clone of Draco Meteor, and Lurantis already has a pretty respectable attack stat. So this thing, being able to make it to a Trailblaze, boost up the Leaf Storm, and then land the Leaf Storm, does so much damage to basically anything. It's insane. Now, there are a couple less battles because I have been busy and was not able to really get to too many battles, so I apologize for that, but let's just get to the battles. Alright, so into the first battle, and we see Venusaur. This isn't really good. However, I can try and catch a Sludge Bomb because both of the Pokemon I have in the back just are going to heavily resist it. Now, I do get the catch of the Sludge Bomb. Clodsire takes zero damage from it, and the opponent then sends in Shadow for Alligator. Now, the thing about Clodsire that I like is that it tanks a Hydro Cannon, and still isn't fun for most Pokemon to farm it down, even after it gets a Hydro Cannon. Now, they will be able to farm it down, but this Earthquake will hit for heavy damage, and Lurantis should have a Trailblaze banked, which does mean that I will win CMP, and unless the opponent wants to go down two shields, which I'm fine with, they'll just lose the Feraligatr. They send in Skeledirge, and that is really not good. Now, Skeledirge, they're probably just looking to commit to a full farm down. I go for the Trailblaze, doesn't do too much. However, I'm going to make it to a Leaf Storm. The opponent has 100 energy, and they're probably thinking they can tank whatever. Nope. They lose 100 energy, and Steelix up a shield into Venusaur just easily sweeps this game now. As Venusaur, they can go for Frenzy Plants, but I have shields, and also Frenzy Plant still doesn't even do half to Steelix, so it's game over. Now, I could go for another Psychic Fangs if I really wanted to, but I honestly think farming them down is just a quicker play, because this match is won no matter what, and we do get a full farm down, and we do take that game. Into the next battle, and we lead Lurantis into Cresselia. Now, Fury Cutter hits her super effective here, which is nice, and I wouldn't be surprised if the opponent does end up switching out simply because they see super effective and think, oh no, super effective. But they can also stay in, because Fury Cutter still does not do too much damage. Now, Trailblaze will not do too much, however, I will actually be able to make it to a Leaf Storm before. And Cresselia is kind of tanky, but Leaf Storm still does enough damage to take him out, and we get the screenshot. The opponent sends in Scrafty, and if they think the Leaf Storm, now that I've been debuffed, is not going to do a lot, they're in for a very nasty surprise, because this is only one stage debuffed, as I did boost my attack before. So this Leaf Storm still hits for heavy damage. Now I can send it in Clodsire, and Scrafty just has nowhere to go here. They can go for any move they want. Clodsire does not really care, even though that foul play was boosted. Now I'm going to throw, I tried to throw right before, and if they shield this, that implies they're very weak in the back. And so they do shield it. And I still don't have to shield here, but I still think I will, because I don't want them to be able to commit both shields and farm down. So now I have back-to-back Sludge Bombs, so I wouldn't be surprised if they let this go through. But they actually don't. Now, I do lose CMP here, but Steelix up a shield still beats basically anything. And I have Clodsire if I need to get a farm down, because this thing still is not going to be easy to farm down by any means. The opponent has Sylveon in the back, though, and yeah, you pretty much know what happened, so I'm just going to speed it up. You can just watch for a couple seconds as Steelix takes that game, and now we're back to regular speed, and we lead Lurantis into Tapu Fini. The opponent immediately switches out into Overquill, of all things, so I respect the spice. I certainly respect the spice on my opponent's end. They go for an Aqua Tail. That was buffed, but it still doesn't do too much. It doesn't get same type attack bonus is the problem. Earthquake takes them out, and now they send in Tapu Fini. Now, if they try and go for a full farm down here, I make three Sludge Bombs. They shield the first one, and now I should be able to make it to two more, honestly. Looking at it, though, I might not be able to. So maybe that was a bit of a miscount, but either way, I actually grab both shields, which is fine. Now, I can send in Lurantis, and Lurantis can go for a Trailblaze. And Trailblaze won't take him out, but they don't have much fast move pressure. They send in a Skuntank, though, and, well, Steelix, it does take super effective from Flamethrower. The only problem is Two flamethrowers will not take out my Steelix. I think if I had the Hundo Steelix like I used to, two flamethrowers might. But now that I have a higher rank one, they can't take me out with two flamethrowers, and Skuntank never farms down, so this game is completely over. They can go for a Crunch, or a flamethrower, or whatever. Steelix tanks anything here, and they still never farm down. They do go for the Crunch, though. It's a nice attempt to bait, but they're not winning. They can send in the Tapu Fini. I'll make it to a Leaf Storm. And we all know Leaf Storm, Draco Meteor Clone, super effective, gets the same type of attack bonus from an already pretty attack-weighted Pokemon like your Lurantis. Bye-bye, Tapu Fini. Now, we see another Cresselia on the lead. I'd be eager to Leaf Storm another one, but this opponent actually does switch out. They send in Obstagoon, and I am going to catch some Night Slash onto Clodsire. Now, they can go for Night Slash after Night Slash after Night Slash. Clodsire really does not care at all. That's the thing I do like about Clodsire, is that it just shuts down Fighting and Fairy types, which are two things that can give my team some trouble. Now, I'm going to be going for an Earthquake. Earthquake does not get shielded, but now they should be basically in Sludge Bomb range. Like, if I farm up to back-to-back Sludge Bombs, the added Mud Shot damage should be able to get them into Sludge Bomb range. So, I am going to actually just no throw here, just not throw. And they can go for a Night Slash, but Clodsire tanks it. Now, if they want to fight for Switch, they're going to have to give up both shields, because this Sludge Bomb here will actually take them out. I get both shields. They get a farm down, but Lurantis gets to actually go for a Trailblaze here, so they're going to lose all their energy, and I'm going to have a boosted Leaf Storm. Now, the opponent sends in a Skeledirge. I was not feeling like trying to make it to a Trailblaze plus a Leaf Storm here, so I just go straight Leaf Storm. It does quite a bit of damage. That was resisted, even though the game doesn't show it. Now, they're going to be going for Shadow Ball. I'm glad I shielded that. They send in Cresselia, but since I'm running Crunch, this game is completely over. They can go for Grass Knot. Steelix really does not care at all. I know I'm saying does not care, but that's kind of what happens when I run bulky Pokemon. Like, Lurantis is kind of spicy. I do have to run something in the back to patch it up. And also, level 50 Clodsire is also pretty spicy, in my opinion. So, I don't think I'm running too much meta here. Now, Steelix with the Crunch is going to do some nice damage on a Cresselia. I will send in Lurantis, and I actually will shield here, because my goal is to bait back out the Skeledirge. So, the opponent does send out the Skeledirge, but I can throw a Leaf Storm. Trailblaze might have KO'd here, but not risking it. Leaf Storm takes him out. They send in Cresselia, and they concede the match. We see Lapras on the lead in the next battle, and I am certainly hoping that they no-shield this Leaf Storm, because Lapras does tank a Leaf Blade, but Leaf Storm is going to do a lot more damage. Leaf Storm, they actually no-shield it, and we nearly one-shot Lapras. Lapras is absurdly bulky as well. They go for an Ice Beam, so it looks like I caught that as well, which is also cool, and then they send in Annihilate. Now, Fighting type into Steel type does seem like a good matchup for the Fighting type, but since we have Psychic Fangs, we actually are able to probably grab a shield here, because now that they're debuffed, the next Psychic Fangs will do some considerable damage. Farm up three Dragon Tails, making sure I'm throwing on good timing, and this Psychic Fangs does get a shield. Now, I can send in Clodsire here. They can go for Ice Punch if they want. We've seen they have it, but there's one kind of problem. Ice Punch doesn't get same type attack bonus, and Clodsire is extremely bulky, so it really still doesn't even look super effective. I'm going to shield here just to preserve some HP, but I don't really think I needed to, in all honesty. I go for the Sludge Bomb, and they shield it, so they're definitely weak in the back. Adding insult to injury, I catch the Ice Punch. I know it's still super effective, but I'd rather take the damage on Lurantis. This ended in Togekiss, though, and yeah, this game is completely over. Because, I mean, we've seen that even in the Master League, this same Clodsire can beat a level 50 Togekiss. So a lower combat power Togekiss is just easy for Clodsire. Two Sludge Bombs, gets the KO, Annihilate, gets farmed down, and we are able to take that game. We lead Lurantis into Gyarados in the next battle. Now, Gyarados is another one of those Pokemon that can tank a Leaf Blade, and they're probably fine with that simply because of the fact that Fury Cutter never farms them down. But Leaf Storm is not Leaf Blade. Leaf Storm nearly takes him out, and we also catch a move. Now, I doubt they went for an Aqua Tail because it's resistant, and we do catch the Crunch, which is amazing. Now, I actually just go for a full farm down. The opponent does transfer the Dragon Tail onto Cresselia, but that's not a good idea, in my opinion. sending Cresselia into Steelix. They probably weren't expecting Crunch, if I'm being honest, because most Steelix do run Earthquake. However, I am on Crunch because I don't really like running Earthquake, so I am going to be able to go for a Crunch. Also, I do say I don't like running Earthquake as I'm running Earthquake on the Clodsire, but I think Steelix is better with Crunch just overall, so that's why I do that. Now, I am going to go for a Psychic Fangs. This will not take out the opponent, but I'm hoping they think it's a Crunch, and it looks like they do. Now, I was hoping that I could survive a Grass Knot here, but I do miscalculate. Even with my higher rank Steelix, it still does get taken out. I send in Lurantis. Lurantis gets the Fury Cutter down, and then they send in Giratina. They even get a catch of a Trailblaze onto the Gyarados, but I'm fine with that. Because the Trailblaze, well, it does take him out. It also boosts my attack, so it's not like I just completely lost the energy. They go for Dragon Tail. Dragon Tail does not take out Lurantis. Now we have a boosted Leaf Storm. Giratina Altered is pretty bulky. Leaf Storm also resisted, but Leaf Storm actually does like half their health. Now it's just easy for Clodsire to clean this up. Dragon Claw, we've seen Clodsire is relatively unbothered by it. They can go for another Dragon Claw. We're still not even in the yellow. Now, I can go for this Earthquake. I don't even care if they shield this, because I'll make it to a second one. They no-shield it, and they're actually going for another Dragon Claw here. Now, this Dragon Claw, actually, they went for a Shadow Sneak, but does the same amount of damage, and we're able to take that game. We see Walrein on the lead in the next battle, and this is the one battle I had Clodsire on Stone Edge, because I wanted to, like, make a video about, like, hunting Talonflame or something, and then I saw, like, none of them in, like, two sets, so I decided that wasn't a good idea. But this one does have one with Stone Edge. And I actually go for the Leaf Storm here. Leaf Storm takes out Walrein. Now the opponent sends in Venusaur. And while I don't want them to get a full farm down, I'm kind of not in the mood to switch out either. Because switching out here would probably let them just go for something into Steelix and then dip if they have a harder counter. So I am just going to let Lurantis get farmed down. Frenzy Plant still will do quite a lot of damage to Steelix. But now I can actually just no-shield the second one as well. I'm just hoping I can put it all on Clodsire, and it's Sylveon in the back, so I can. Now, even though I'm not running Sludge Bomb, this is absurdly one-sided. Clodsire, even in no shield, still crushes Sylveon, even though Psy Shock is super effective. But when there's shields up, it's fine. I can even no-shield Psy Shock anyways. I don't even care. I can just save both shields for Steelix, because Venusaur never farms down, and that's fine. Now, the opponent gets taken out by the Earthquake. But if they think they're going to have to CMP time me when I make it to the Earthquake, they're wrong, because I am running Stone Edge. This is probably the one use I got of Stone Edge, but whatever. Now, I'm going to go for Psychic Fangs. Psychic Fangs, they actually no-shield it, which is pretty impressive to me, honestly, the fact that they knew it wouldn't KO, but the fact that Dragon Tails will farm down is also just going to cost them the game. Alright, so overall, Leaf Storm Lurantis, the thing is very, very fun. Like, the fact that you can just one-shot some things without them even realizing that they're about to get one-shot is especially fun, because a lot of people do know that, like, Lurantis really does not run that. Heck, I don't even think many people know that it learns it. Like, most people just think Leaf Blade plus Superpower, or the occasional Trailblaze user. The fact that it runs Leaf Storm is extremely fun, in my opinion. Now, my backline of Clodsire and Steelix was also very impressive. It is kind of an ABB-style team, trying to, like, bait out, like, the Swampert or any other ground or water types. And it pretty much did its job, honestly. Anyway, that's pretty much it for today's video. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one.